Hi guys, it's Julie and I have a new video for you today. I'm going to be doing some DIY foiled letterpress using the Gemini foil press, which I got a few days before Creativation down in Phoenix, and I got to play with it for a few days before I left, and then I started playing with it again when I got home because I'm having a ton of fun with this thing. So I've powered up the unit there, and that will turn on the main power, and then there's a power switch on the left-hand side there on top of the machine for turning on the heating element. And I did want to mention that when you're connecting the platform itself to the power base, you want to make sure that you're sliding it straight in and straight out every time. You do not want to tilt it upward or get sloppy, you know, and it's angling it in left or right. Just straight in and straight out. Otherwise, you could damage that connector. It's going to come with a metal shim and a silicone mat and a polycarbon plate, but you may possibly need your metal shim or your magnetic shim from your Gemini Junior, depending on the different things that you're going to be doing with this foil press. The manual or user guide, it's very important to go over that. It tells you everything that comes in the starter box, and then it has a matrix there that tells you the thickness of materials you could be working with, the size of the die, how long to heat it and set the timer for, yada, yada, yada. Now, I went ahead and downloaded the matrix over at Crafter's Companion itself, and then I printed it out on my printer and used washi tape to tape it inside my cabinet where I primarily work with this machine, so I can quickly open that door and see what I need to double check. But once you get used to it, you probably won't need to reference it very often unless you switch materials. I'm primarily working with paper in this video. So I did also want to mention something that you may find helpful. I don't know, I'm trying it out. Maybe it's not helpful, but I made a template out of vellum cardstock. I cut a piece of vellum cardstock that was the same size as that whole platform there, and then I used a 4.25 by 5.5 inch die to cut out an A2 size opening, and you'll see more about that in a minute. I did want to show you what the dies that we're working with look like. They look like stamps, but they're made out of metal. And there's also foil and cut versions that Crafter's Companion has made. So on the left is a foil and cut, and on the right, it's basically a metal stamp for hot stamping or hot foil stamping. You can also use any of your low profile dies as long as they're not over 1 millimeter thick and get the details of those outlines. So this is a really pretty pink fresh die that you could use. So look in your dies, your collection, and see what else you can do with them, because you're going to have a lot of fun combining them with the foiling here. So I've taken a piece of washi tape and I'm going to anchor down my template that I made from vellum cardstock here on the platform. And the reason I'm doing this is that it helps me visually plan my layout. I get an idea of the spacing because I'm going to be working upside down, right? The dies are designed up at me instead of the reverse, where I'm putting them face down onto a card front. So I have to think backwards a little bit. So this is going to help me space things out and plan things out, because I know that that's basically the size of my A2 card front. So I'm taking the foil stamps first, and I'm going to make a card with that. And this is going to give me a really cool letterpress effect, because it's going to deboss these images. It's not going to do any cutting. These are just metal stamps. They're going to hot foil the images into my paper. So I'm planning this out within that A2 size using that piece of vellum as my guide. Now, I don't know if it's going to be helpful for you, but I'm trying it, okay? So now I'm going to power on the heating element, and it's red right now. And I'm going to wait until it turns green. So I'm just going to la-di-da, time is going to pass. And once it turns green, I'll be ready to actually proceed. In the meantime, while I'm waiting, I'm going to show you that I'm working with a quarter sheet of Essentials by Ellen letterpress paper, which is a lovely, luxurious paper. And I've got my foil already cut to roughly the same size as that piece of paper. And it's just a little bit larger than that. And I'm going to grab the polycarbon plate. Now, this is different from the cutting pad that comes with your Gemini Junior. This is a heat-resistant, tough-as-nails kind of plate that you're... Once that light there on the low setting has turned green, it tells me that it has preheated to the temperature it needs to be. And I'm going to go ahead and lay my foil down. I've already pre-cut it just a little bit larger than my quarter sheet of Essentials by Ellen letterpress paper. I'm going to close the template now, and that's so that I know exactly where to position this letterpress paper. So all the stuff I've got as far as the layout goes, it's going to land where I want it on that, because you can't see through the foil, right? You can't see through the paper, so you're operating blind here. And then I set the timer for 10 seconds. And then once it beeped at me, I grabbed my polycarbon plate, put that down on top. And then I pulled the platform away from the connector and went ahead and sent it through my Gemini Junior. Now, I'm not going to reconnect it right now. I want it to continue cooling down. I don't want it to continue heating because then I'll burn out the element. And you need to take care of your platform if you want it to last a long time. And I'm going to go ahead and lift up all that other stuff and flip that over, and you can see I've got a really good foil press going on here. You can just tell by looking at that. So when I peel this away, and I didn't really wait that long for it to cool off because I was so excited. And then I was like, yes, I've got professional looking results. And I tell you what, this turned out consistent every time I followed the steps and did it. And so I'm super excited about this. And I noticed I did have a little bit of excess foil along that top edge there. To fix that, I'm just going to grab my sand eraser and I'm going to very gently kiss the surface of the paper. It may look like I'm being aggressive, but I'm not. I'm just very lightly brushing it across the top, and it's going to take off all that excess foil up there, and you would never know it was there. But you do want to be gentle because it's letterpress paper and it's, you know, it's delicate to things that are abrasive like a sand eraser. Then I'm going to use the tweezers, they're magnetic, to remove those hot dyes and let them cool off on the silicone mat. So I've once again put a dye I want to work with. This is that gorgeous Pink Fresh Studios dye that has a really intricate pattern and design, and the light turned green, so I'm ready to go ahead and put my foil down, and then I'm going to grab another piece of letterpress paper. I'm doing a horizontal layout. I've got it kind of justified to the side there. Set the timer, and then once the timer goes off, now there seems to be no consensus as to when you put that polycarbon plate down or not. Do you have to wait till the beeper goes off or not? I haven't noticed it makes a difference exactly when I put that carbon plate down, so I haven't been paying much attention to that. And then when I came back to the machine, after I sent it through my Gemini Junior, I did power off the unit up there with the left side power button so that it would stop heating. Now I'm going to peel away this gorgeous rose gold foil that I used, and you can see that the pattern has transferred to that letterpress paper. Now don't throw away the waste. You can use it, even though I'm not doing that in this video today. You will be able to use the waste, so don't toss it. Save it. I did want to find out if I could do a full-size card front, like a standard U.S. A2 card front, 4 1/4 by 5 1/2. So I made my base card out of craft card stock, got it scored, folded it, and then I set it up on the platform, and I'm going to use a little bit of washi tape there to anchor it down along the top of the platform. It doesn't heat up along that white portion up there. Only the purple area heats up, and it heats from all the edges. It's all over. There's no hot spots and cold spots. It's all over heat. I know there's a word for that, but it just goes all over the whole purple area there. And I'm going to be able to flip that card front up and see exactly a space of that fits an A2 card front. So this was like, wow, what a stroke of luck. So I can plan my layout and use the grid lines there on the purple mat to make sure that my die is lined up and positioned exactly where I'm going to want it to show up on my card front. And then I went ahead and allowed it to preheat. And once the light turns green, I can go ahead and lay my foil down, set the timer for 10 seconds, and wait for that to beep at me. And then once it beeps at me, I'm going to go ahead and take my card front and fold it down over the foil. And then I can go ahead and take that polycarbon plate and put that over the top. So I pulled it from the base after the beeper went off, and then I folded the card front down, and I'm going to lay that polycarbon plate on top. This is not the same as a cutting pad from your Gemini Junior. It's very durable material when it comes to heat resistant. So you cannot use a cutting pad from your Gemini Junior for this. So now I've gone ahead and reconnected it to the base. I did power it off, so it's not heating anymore. And then you can see I've got a gorgeous foiled effect. I did neutralize my washi tape before I taped it down by rubbing it against my inner arm so that it would not be quite so tacky. But look at this gorgeous rose gold foiled effect on my craft card stock. I need to get some copper foil because I'm going to love doing the copper on the craft card stock. But anyway, it turned out perfect. So I'm super stoked. So now I'm going to make a little tag, and this is the foil and cut die. And you want to use a different sandwich. I used a different sandwich. I did not have good results with the sandwich that they used in the manual. So I had to play around with this and wasted about three tags to figure out what worked for me. And I put the die down, then I put my foil, then my cardstock, and I'm working on 80-pound Nina cardstock. I'm going to plug that in, preheat it, and then put the metal shim from my Gemini Junior on top, a cardstock shim, and then the polycarbon plate. And that's how I got my results. And I'll have some notes on my blog post that tell you exactly what sandwich worked for me when I was doing the foil and cut, because what the manual had did not work for me. I ended up getting foil all over the place, and I was like, okay, that's not working. So once I played with it and I figured it out, I made note of it. So once you find that sweet spot that works for you, then make sure you write some notes so you don't forget. And then, of course, I had just a little blem there of foil. I took the sand eraser and sanded that away very quickly and easily. So that sand eraser is going to be your best friend when it comes to any stray foil marks. And there you go. I've got a debossed letterpress effect that is beautifully foiled with that rose gold copper. It looks so gorgeous. I'm so excited. I can actually do foiled letterpress effects at home, and I'm getting consistent results. They turn out beautiful every time. And I hope you enjoyed this video. Check out the notes I have over on my blog post, and thanks for watching.